What's up, guys? Shuri here, and today we are going to do the Cyclops and Reaper, but first I want to tell you about my channel memberships. We have it set up to where you can get all these cool perks for just $2, and you can get some extra perks if you do the $5 or $10, and help me get some audio equipment. I would appreciate it, but if you don't have the money, then just hit the like button. I'll appreciate that too. Alright, we're going to start out with the Reaper. And one thing I want to say is people who are saying shotguns are bad and this update's bad, I technically agree with you. But I think that shotguns aren't as bad as you think. And I think they balance shotguns in this patch is an overall positive thing. The negative part is for 3 to 4 months, they had instant shot snipers if you were shooting them and then switched your gun. And now if you're shooting them and then you switch your gun, you cannot shoot for double the amount of time that the gun will allow, which is awful. Like, that is so bad to make people get used to instant shot and then go to basically you just have to sit there and die. It's kind of the dumbest thing I've ever seen in my life, but hey, it's God. So what we're going to have to do is make sure that when we see someone, we are switching early to our shotgun. That way, that time will pass, and by the time we get to them, we are fine. You can see right here, I'm going to go ahead and switch right here and then come around. And that way, we will be able to shoot them. And I am using phone. I decided to switch devices right as they updated, which is not the smartest move, but it's a Shuri move, so that's what we're going to do, and we are going to actually do pretty good on phone. I am going and getting better at phone, that way I can do my hand cam video and show you guys how to do 3-finger call and 4-finger call, and then also show you a little bit of ways that you can do 2 fingers better as well. But please go to 3 or 4 fingers, it will help you so much, and I will show you how to do that. It's going to take me like a week to get used to it enough to be able to do it, and then we'll have that done. Anyways, we're going to keep going on, and we are getting the double here. We're going to go ahead and try to kill the third person. They got to one shot. My teammates were able to clean it up, and we were able to get that hill back, and that is all that matters. And this Reaper is fun as can be. It drops those little things on the ground. Since you can't knife anybody anyways, hey, it's great. And right here, we are going to be flashed. We go ahead and get out of there. We're going to wait for the door since we know that it just opened. We know where they're going to come from. And we're going to just sit here with our Reaper ready for them. And we do work. We're going to go ahead and get the double. And then we have 2 more rushing us straight on. And we are going to go ahead and get one with that grenade. We're going to wait for our teammates. We have all of our armor because of jockey pants and Reaper, like, pyramids, I guess you would call them. Sorry, I've never thought about that before. Anyways, we're going to go ahead and get our little pyramids and get full armor. And it is going to be great. That allowed us to get the killing spree. And now we're going to move on to the next game where we have already killed some people, as you can tell by the pyramids. But we got some speed right here from those and some extra armor. And we are going to go ahead and take out both of those guys' undyings. And our teammates were able to kind of clean it up. Right here, we're going to go in and just do what we can. We get the double. And then we see another one. We're going to go ahead and get the triple with our scout. We're going to go ahead and switch right now to our Reaper. Go ahead and get that 4 at once and just keep going. We do end up dying before the 5 at once. But, I mean, it happens. So, we're going to keep going and just try to do what we can with our Reaper, which is a whole lot. So you see that I'm switching early because that is the key, and it will help you just so much because, honestly, if you switch late, you're just going to die. You're going to sit there and not shoot, and it's super annoying. So, you got to make sure you're switching that weapon early, and shotguns really aren't that bad. But it is going to seem that way at first because they did this update in the worst way possible because they decided that they are going to make it to where everyone should go up close, shooting them with their gun, switch to their shotgun. That way they can instant shot and do that for 3 months, making everyone basically be forced to do it. Otherwise, they're going to die because other people are doing it. And then about 3-4 months later, they decide, hey, now we should make it, if you're going up to them with a gun and switch your shotgun, you get penalized now. And that's just not cool. Like, you can't do that to people. And that's why this update seems as bad as it is. But I think that as soon as you get used to the fact of, hey, make sure that you switch to your shotgun before you get to them, it will be so much better. And overall, I think that it's a net positive for this update because all of these shotguns, like the Reaper, Exorcist, like they've been really bad. Like, really bad. And now they are able to be used. Same with Pork and Joker and Dolores, which were all already good. I am making a shotgun video that goes through all of the major shotguns. And so far, it is like 25 minutes long, so we're probably going to have that be like a part 1 and 2 video. But either way, it will show you how to use all of the shotguns and exactly what those shotguns can do. That way, you can know what shotgun you want to use and just see how balanced everything kind of is. Like, it really does suck. The whole switching your weapon thing, if they get rid of that, I think shotguns are in the best place they've been in years. And Bear Trap and Ranger are just casualties, man. The majority of the people that were telling Gob, hey, we got to get this Bear Trap to be destroyed, Bear Trap had a 60% win rate, and Ranger was probably just right there as well. And that's why they nerfed them to death, because that's what the community wanted, the majority of them. And it really sucks, because all it was the instant shot shotgun glitch that was making it so OP. Everything else was balanced about Bear Trap and Ranger too. And so to get rid of them really just sucks. And I mean, it is what it is. You can't really blame Gob on that one, because that's what the community wanted. Just because you're smart enough to know that, hey, we only need to get rid of the instant shot, that does not mean the majority were, because they were asking for this. So Gob gave us what we wanted, and it just sucks that we wanted it. So I just wanted to put that out there, because a lot of people are giving Gob crap for killing Bear Trap, and they kind of should. But we also should take some responsibility, because honestly, they gave us what we asked for. I mean, it is what it is. Either way, these rocket bots from Alpha are really annoying, and I get it. All of those guys were really scared and afraid of my Exorcist. It was a very good gun. We're going to go ahead and look. Oh, 44 Hall of Fames with rockets. Oh, 29 Hall of Fames with rockets. What do you know? That's crazy. Oh, another 43 Hall of Fames with rockets. I wonder how they did that. Anyways, we're going to move on and keep going. We're going to try to be able to kill some people in this hill, because Exorcist is super strong. It's a little bit weak against multiple people, so you do got to be careful with that. And you got to make sure that you reload it when you can. But you also got to make sure you don't get caught out reloading. Right there, that is one of the weaknesses of Exorcist. You do need to lead your shots a little bit, because it decides to just shoot behind people, because I think it just takes a little while to get done, so by the time it actually shoots, the person's not there anymore, so you kind of have to lead your shots slightly. But other than that, it's been pretty good. I don't think it's like the best shotgun in the game. I don't think Reaper is either. I think they're both good and viable shotguns, and that's why I wanted to make this video. The Reaper and Exorcist are viable. Like, that's great. That's what we wanted. We wanted balance. You can use all the shotguns besides Bear Trap and Ranger, and it's really great. I mean, just think about it. Like, when's the last time you could use this many shotguns in the meta and not suffer for you choosing it? Like, that is so great. And I really enjoy the fact that I can use these kind of things, because it's fun to use different stuff and play a little different. And the coolest part is everyone's worried about people camping with Orochi. That's not really what's happening. Not in my games, at least. Outside of the maps like Europe Streets and Mexico Church, which, I mean, a lot of Orochi campers are doing it. I mean, and those maps are fine. It's Slayer, and I kind of get it. But it hasn't been like everyone thinks, where like rushing is completely done, because I've been winning like every game by rushing, and a lot of other people are rushing too. And it is going to be really good to be able to use the shotguns you want and not just Bear Trap or Ranger and not have to be punished for it. That is a huge thing, and I think it's really cool. I think they did a better job on this update than they're going to get credit for, because they so royally screwed up on this update. You cannot put people from an instant shot switch your gun meta to a switch your gun and you auto die and not shoot for a second meta. That is stupid. You cannot do that. And they took so long to fix it. And then when they fixed it, they did it in the worst way possible. But if they can just get that delay out, it will be amazing, I promise you guys. These shotguns are super balanced. It's great. Bear trap, it sucks what happened to it, but that's what the community asked for. So, I mean, it is what it is. Bear trap had its moment in the sun, I guess. And it just flew too close to it, and it is what it is. And I'm just happy that you can use Exorcist and Reaper and other shotguns like crazy. I'm going to show you guys exactly all the techniques, the benefits, and the cons of using each gun. And it's going to take me a while because that's a lot to do. But I did want to show you guys that you really can use any of these guns in this meta, because I'm using Cyclops. Like, that is so insane to me that Cyclops is actually viable. And I'm able to do it very easily. It's not just like one thing where I get like a few kills here and there. That's why I wanted to make sure in both of these that I included the entire game. Because everything doesn't go my way, but a lot of it does. And it's important to show that, hey, it's not just like, hey, I got this random multi-kill that was really lucky. It's this whole game was just domination. I love this Cyclops, or I keep calling it Cyclops, it's Exorcist, and I love it. It was really terrible before, and everyone wanted me to use it, and I didn't want to, because it sucked. But now it's not that bad, and it's pretty fun to use. So I see the appeal. I think I'm going to use Reaper a lot, but I think that probably Orion, Porcupine, and Joker are going to be your top three shotguns right now in this meta. I'm not 100% sure because I just haven't played it enough to know exactly. But at the very least, I can give you that pros and cons video for each of the shotguns and how to play with them with the new style of shotgun you gotta do. And as soon as you get used to the new way of rushing, it's really not that bad. You just gotta think in your head, hey, I need to make sure I switch to my shotgun earlier than I'm used to, and you will be able to do it. The biggest thing for me was to make sure that I had throwing knives, because throwing knives erase all mistakes. But the biggest thing that helped me with learning the new way of shotgun is just going ahead and playing and making sure that I said in my head and always made sure I was thinking about, hey, make sure you get your shotgun out. And then if you do it enough, you'll stop having to think about it and it'll just be natural to you. And that's how you're going to have to adjust, is just by doing it. And that sucks a lot because it's no fun to like do bad. And that's one of Exorcist's weaknesses, is people strafing. Also, you cannot use this gun with aim off. I swear to God, it's so terrible with aim off. So if you're an aim off player, I wouldn't use the Exorcist. It's not great. But we are going to go out and try to do what we can. We get shot and we're going to immediately go to our Exorcist. And we do it early enough to be able to start shooting them before we get close to them. So Exorcist doesn't have the problem of switching to it and not being able to shoot. Because it's a wind-up thing, it'll shoot immediately. But the problem is it doesn't actually shoot immediately. It'll just start winding up. So you still want to switch it early like you would with any other shotgun, because you can end up being able to shoot them because you're having your circle go while you're basically not in good damage range. And by the time you're starting to shoot, you'll be in good damage range. So you need to make sure that you switch to that Exorcist while you still have some distance on the person. Even if it's not to do the instant shot thing, it is really helpful to be able to get a lot of damage, especially since that last shot is what's going to give you most of your damage. Right there, we get a nice triple. I wanted to go for a four at once, but it just wasn't in the cards. We do get him low with the throwing knife, though, trying to help our teammate. Like I said, throwing knives can erase all mistakes. Right here, I'm literally learning this. It was my first game with the Exorcist, and I literally had no idea how to use it, and I realized real quick that you don't want to try to use this thing at long range, oh my god. But you do want to make sure it's starting up and winding up when you got some distance on them, because their shotgun doesn't need to wind up. So it does help a lot if you can go ahead and start that process before their shotgun's able to do big damage. Right here, we are going to go and kill one of them, get the other one to one shot and slow them. which is going to basically secure our victory. I get my butt kicked right there, but I did kill him with my frost grenade, so I'm happy with it. Our teammate kills that guy on the bridge while he rockets us, and then we see that guy in front of us, but the game's over. And honestly, guys, I think the game's in a good place. I think that it's in a terrible place with players, and there's bots at Platinum, so that sucks. But I think like the actual game they've made isn't that bad right now. We just got to get used to it. But I'm wrong, maybe. I don't know. Like, I haven't really played it enough to be able to say like for sure that I think it's in a great place. So we'll see after I play some more. Anyways, thank you to my channel members so much. You guys are helping me get that audio equipment. I really do appreciate it. It is going to make things a lot easier for me. I don't have to use my iPad like 3 inches from my mouth, which is kind of weird, so I really do appreciate it. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, and you have a great day.